Lieutenant, Grand General Brashin has authorized me to supervise your training.
And I'll expect a full report on his performance, Captain Toulon.
Very good, sir. I trust you are familiar with the battlefield holographic control interface?
Only in passing, sir.
Divided into several sections, the main screen is a three-dimensional representation of the information received from the battlefield. Navigating this virtual world is one of the more challenging aspects of your command, but it is vital for gaining control over your units. And remember, Lieutenant, all of this information is represented in the BHCI reference manual. I suggest you review it before you're in the middle of combat. I'm initiating the online training program. Now then, we're going to move the camera forward and backwards. Good. Let's try moving the camera left and right. You're a quick study, Lieutenant. Tilting up and down is also possible. Your camera will automatically maintain its focus point while doing so. Now then, there are a few other ways to move the camera. These will both be invaluable in finding the enemy and your own units. One is orbit, which keeps a stationary target point and rotates the camera around it. The other is pan, which causes the camera itself to rotate. Let's try that now. Very good, Lieutenant. There's just one more camera move to learn for now, and that is zoom in and out. Excellent. One thing to keep in mind, all of these camera moves are duplicated on the mouse as well. Take a few moments to familiarize yourself with them, then we can continue. I've never seen an officer candidate pick that up as fast as you did, Lieutenant. You were an excellent choice. Now let's learn how to command your troops.
Yes, sir.
See that sand trooper out there? He's an advanced scout of Zeta Squadron. Let's get his attention. Go ahead, Lieutenant. Try it.
Trooper, ready and able.
Let's move the trooper now.
Stormtrooper reporting as ordered.
See the bright region around the sand trooper. That represents the limit of the unit's sight. Any other enemy units will not be visible in the BHCI until they fall into that area. If you look at the middle of the BHCI, the selected unit's unique characteristics are shown. This area is called the leader display. The unit's health, rank, designation, and personal name are all presented. You can change his personal name at any time to better track your units. Go ahead and try it.
Stormtrooper reporting as ordered.
Cargo doors.
Ah, good. The rest of Zeta Squadron has arrived. It will give me a chance to show you how to select multiple units.
Here I am, Bren.
Icons have shown up in the BHCI. This area is called the group display. Along with the unit in the leader display, it shows the representation of a group of units. Now let's deselect the group. That will do. Now locate and select a Dubak trooper from Zeta Squadron. Remember to use what you've learned about the camera. The Dubak is a special type of unit called a carrier. He can carry a trooper on his back. See how the group display area has changed. It now shows a sand trooper icon. This is the unit being carried by the Dubak. We're going to order him to dismount now.
I'm planet side now, sir.
The other way to quickly disembark from a carrier is to use the unload all button, which shows up in the BHCI's command bar. The command bar is located above the group display area and automatically detects which type of unit you've selected, setting the commands appropriately. Your troop carrier and speeder bikes will function in the same way as the Dubac. Let's get that sand trooper back on the Dubac. All of your humanoid units have the ability to board or mount a carrier.
Trooper, ready and able. Stormtrooper, ready, sir.
Commander, you're under attack. Let's show them the...
Yes, Commander! Stormtrooper, ready, sir.
Very good, Lieutenant. You've conducted yourself well. Never engage the locals unless they first provoke you. You're a soldier, not a murderer.
Yes, sir.
Enemies are easy to spot if you stay alert. They first show up on the strategic map, the square display screen to the left of the BHCI. This is a stationary overview of the battlefield. The dark regions represent unexplored areas of the battlefield or regions that are deemed not relevant to the mission at hand. The blue contacts represent units that you can control as an agent of the Empire, in this case, Zeta Squadron. Red contacts are enemies of the Empire. Yellow represents neutral units, and white contacts are your currently selected units. The contact flashes between white and its color when combat occurs. There are other types of contacts. If you're curious, I would suggest you consult the BHCI manual. One other way to get a different perspective on the battlefield is to attach your camera to a specific unit. This is very helpful when exploring or engaging in combat. Let's attach to a unit. Excellent, Lieutenant. Your camera is now attached to the selected unit. You may find it easier to orchestrate your attacks while in this mode. All of the camera commands are still available. Feel free to try them out at your leisure. Now let's return to free camera mode. Good. Your camera has now been restored to full mobility. Now let me show you how to engage in a secondary attack.
This is General Brashear, and I hope you're a quick study, Lieutenant, because we've just received a transmission from Lord Vader. The Corellian escape pod is ejected from a rebel...
Are you taking your training seriously, Lieutenant?
Stormtrooper reporting as ordered.
Look, sir. Droids.
Lieutenant, this is Delos. We found signs of droids in the area.
Thank you, Trooper.